Joining us now in the studio for a deeper look at Prime Minister Netanyahu's India visit is former Israeli ambassador to multiple countries, including Mexico and New Zealand, Ambassador Yosef Livne. Thank you very much for coming back in.
My pleasure.
All right, so my first thing is, you know, Netanyahu has just gone with a very large delegation at his back. What kinds of deals and agreements can you expect to come out of this trip?
Well, I think that the size of the and the scope of the delegation reflects the importance of India on the world scene, especially for Israel. I mean, as the Prime Minister himself said, it's a world power with multiple opportunities in agriculture, in high tech, in many other fields. And I think that the fact that so many people joined the delegation reflects the awareness and the recognition in Israel that we have an opening, that we should do whatever we can to take advantage of.
So that actually brings me to my next question, is who gets to decide who goes on, in who joins this delegation? Because you just said, you know, a lot of people wanted to be on this trip to India. Do you say that, you know, as opposed to other trips?
No, I think that in most cases, in many most countries, when a prime minister or president travels abroad, usually you have a trade delegation tagging along, especially when you know that there is an opportunity to develop the prospects of trade deals. Mm-hmm. Now, I don't know exactly how it works, but I'm certain that, you know, the Prime Minister's office lets people know, look, there's going to be a visit, and there will be so many places on the plane, on the delegation, and then people have to work their way, convince whoever needs to be convinced of the importance, why they should be there on the plane or in the delegation. But I heard this morning, this afternoon, someone saying that he was going, I think he's the head of the Indian Israel, the Israel Indian Chamber of Commerce, he's still here, he's going overseas tomorrow night, I think. So, yeah,
so it looks
like
their delegation might even grow.
Okay,
so now another thing that I wanted to kind of get back to in our last minute here is that Netanyahu has often called Narendra Modi a friend. They seem to be very, you know, they had a warm embrace there when he landed. But it's a very political thing to call other leaders around the world your friend when in reality, how many friendships really exist in the executive level? So my question is, you know, how friendly are we really beneath the surface when we have them voting against us at the UN, for example, or, you know, et cetera?
Look, I think that we have to put everything in perspective. Mm-hmm. I mean, yeah, the vote on Jerusalem was something that was painful, in a way. But relations between countries have multiple strata. Mm-hmm. So you have the political, you have the economic, you have the cultural, and you have so many other issues. Of this, of the over 100 countries that voted against the U.S. and Israel, there were many countries with whom we have very friendly relations.
So you're saying it's
on other issues.
So that's kind of just like leave
I don't
that
know.
Be,
it must
not.
Have look. You'd love. Mm. I'm sure that everybody would have loved India to abstain or to be absent.
Sure.
But it's a country that has interests in Israel as well as in other places.
Mm. It takes those all into account.
Exactly.
All right. Ambassador Yosef Livne, thank you very much for coming back in.
Thank you.